What should business owners or their admin staff put on their invoices that they're going to send out to clients? If you are GST registered, it's really important to have five things on there, which is tax invoice number, a date, a description of the goods and services that you're selling. Be very clear that you've got your GST registered number on the invoice. You want an exclusive amount, the GST component of 15%, and a total payable on that invoice. Other things that are good for you in terms of like getting paid would be bank account details to be paid into and your terms and conditions. But you can actually Google it, you know, what are the specific requirements I need on a tax invoice in New Zealand, and Inland Revenue will come up with a reminder that there's five key things that you have to have on there as a requirement for a tax invoice. As a business owner, you need to understand what is my tax structure and what IRD number am I using. And if you are a business, for example, and you think that you're going to do taxable sales over $60,000 in any given year, you should be GST registered. If you're GST registered, when you go and do that registration, you should be really careful about how you set that up. So that's always good to check in with an accountant and get some advice around that. I think a lot of business owners are kind of getting GST registered, and those are quite a few hurdles, and if you get that wrong, that can be problematic down the track. So again, rather than sort of guessing or Googling or whatever, these are the kind of questions that if you're unsure, you should actually make contact with a professional such as GoFi8ure, who can actually explain these things to you and why. We love basically getting your invoices simple and automated with no issues, and we also have a debt collection service here. You know, it's very nice and it's processed using the software, so why not? The money should be in your bank account, not your clients.